Then this minus d upon dt becomes 0. The equation becomes dx upon dt is equal to k 0. This is the equation 2. Dx upon dt is equal to k 0. This is the equation 2. Then we integrate this equation 2 between the limits. We integrate the equation 2 between the limits for x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x for concentration. Between the limit x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x for concentration x, and t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t for time. We integrate this equation 2 between the limit. Dx is a change in concentration. The change in concentration 0 to x, and for time, initial time 0 to t is equal to t. Then substitute this limit. Dx upon dt, x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x is equal to k 0. T is equal to 0 to t is equal to t. The integration of dx upon dt is x. Integration of dx upon dt is equal to x. Upper limit x is equal to x. Lower limit x is equal to 0. Sorry, because first. Sorry, first rearrange this equation. Dx is equal to k 0 dt. Rearrange this equation. Dx upon dt is equal to k 0. The dx is equal to k 0 dt. And this is the equation number 3. Integrate the equation 3 between the limit for concentration x. X is equal to 0 to x is equal to x. And for time, t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t. The first rearrange this equation, dx upon dt is equal to k 0, dx is equal to k 0 dt. Then integrating this equation for concentration, x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x, dx is equal to k 0 is a constant, for time t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t dt. The dx have integration x. The dx have integration x, and dt have integration t. The k 0 is a constant. Dt has integration t. Upper limit t is equal to t. Lower limit t is equal to 0. Then substituting upper and lower limit, x is equal to x, x is equal to 0, x is equal to x, x is equal to 0, k 0, t is equal to t is equal to 0, it becomes x is equal to k 0 t. Then k 0 is equal to x upon t. This is the equation number 4. This equation number 4 is integrated red equation for the zero order reaction. K0 is equal to x upon t. This equation 4 is integrated form of red equation for the zero order reaction. To derive the integrated form of red equation for zero order reaction, we consider this reaction A is converted to the product. For this zero order reaction, Ca is the concentration of reactant A. Rate of zero order reaction remains constant. It does not depend on time. At time changes, rate of zero order reaction remains constant. It does not depend on concentration of reactant. The rate of zero order reaction is equal to K0. What is the K0? K0 is a rate constant for zero order reaction. For this chemical reaction, we can write differential form of red equation, minus dCa upon dt is equal to k0. If A is small, A is a mole of initial concentration of reactant A at a time t is equal to 0. A X is a reactant concentration. Up top the initial concentration A. X is a concentration, reactant concentration after some time T. Then unreacted concentration is A minus X. Then Ci is equal to A minus X. We substitute in equation 1, Ci is equal to A minus X. This equation becomes minus dA upon minus D in bracket A minus X upon dt is equal to K0. Then solve this minus dA upon dt plus dx upon dt is equal to K0. dA upon dt remains constant, it's 0. dx upon dt is equal to k0. This is the equation 2. We can rearrange this. dx is equal to k0 dt. Then equation 3, we integrate between the limit for concentration x. x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x. And for time t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t. Then integrating this equation, x is equal to 0 to x is equal to x dx, k0 is a rate constant, 0 order rate constant, for time t0 is equal to t. Integration of dx is a x, substituting upper and lower limit. Integration of dt is a t, substitute upper limit x is equal to x minus x is equal to 0, x minus 0. Substitute the integration limit for time t is equal to t is equal to 0. This becomes x is equal to k0t. We rearrange this, k0 is equal to x upon t. The equation 4 is rate constant equation for the zero order reaction. It is integrated form of rate equation for the zero order reaction. K0 is equal to x upon t. The k0 is equal to x upon t. This equation indicates rate of reaction, rate constant of zero order reaction is independent on initial concentration. Rate constant equation, K0 initial rate constant of zero order reaction is independent on initial concentration A. K0 is equal to X upon T. This is the integrated rate equation for the zero order reaction. K0 is equal to x upon t. Then consider the characteristic for the zero order reaction. Then what are the characteristics for the zero order reaction? Then consider the characteristics for the zero order reaction. Characteristics of zero order reaction. What are the characteristics? Then consider the first, nature of graph. Nature of graph. What is the nature of graph for the zero order reaction? Consider the characteristics for the zero order reaction. First, characteristic for the zero order reaction is nature of graph. We already discussed rate constant equation for zero order reaction. X is equal to k0t or k0. This is the rate constant equation for zero order reaction, or k0 is equal to x upon t. This is the rate constant equation for zero order reaction. In plotting the graph, concentration x against the time, we obtain the graph. This equation, concentration x, is plotted against this time. Then what is the nature of graph? X is equal to k0t. The rate constant equation for zero order reaction is similar to the straight line equation y is equal to mx. There is no intercept, means this straight line passing through the origin. This is the nature of graph. Plotting concentration x against the time t, we obtain the graph. In this graph, the nature of graph are generally the straight line passing through the origin. X is equal to k0t. This equation are similar to the straight line equation y is equal to mx plus y is equal to mx. Y is plotted against m is a slope. For this equation, slope is k0. the slope is equal to k0. This is the nature of graph. For the zero order reaction, the straight line R, by plotting concentration x against the time t, the straight line R passing through the origin. X is equal to k0t, this is the rate constant equation for zero order reaction, and this is the similar to the straight line equation. Y is equal to mx, the straight line are passing through origin, the straight line are passing through origin without intercept, and slope is equal to k0. Then consider the second property, half life period. The half life period, what is the definition of half life period? Represented by T half. What is the definition of half life period? The time required for completion of 50% reaction, means about the initial concentration. Out of the initial concentration, the 50% concentration is reacted, and 50% concentration is unreacted. This time are generally known as half life period. The time at which the 50% reactant is reactive and behind 50% reactant is unreactive, this time is known as half-life period. The time at which the 50% reaction is completed and 50% reaction is uncompleted, this 50% reactant is unreactive, this time is known as half-life period. The time required for 50% completion of the reaction is known as half-life period. This is known as half-life period. If T is equal to T half, if the T is equal to T half, if the time is T half, half-life period, then initial concentration is A. At that time, at half-life period, at time t, the concentration is A. What is the half-life period? The time at which the half of the reactant reacted, 50% reactant is reacted and 50% reactant is unreacted, this time is known as half-life period. This x becomes A by 2. Initial concentration is A. When t is equal to t half, then x is equal to A by x is the concentration on, it is a reactive concentration. What is the reactive concentration? T half, at that time reactive concentration is 50%, means A by 2. What is the T half? T half is a half life period. What is the definition of half life period? Time required for completion of 50% reaction is known as half life period. The time required for 50% completion of reaction is known as the half-life period, or the time at which 50% reactant is reacted and 50% reactant is unreacted. The 50% reactant is reacted and leaving behind 50% reactant is unreacted. This time is known as half-life period. The time required for completion of 50% reaction is known as half-life period. When T is equal to T half, then A is the initial concentration, then reactive concentration, X is the reactive concentration. It becomes at T half is equal to, at T, if at T half, at half-life period, reactive concentration becomes A by 2. Then consider rate equation for the zero order reaction is equal to K0 is equal to, K0 is equal to x upon t. K0 is equal to x upon t. If we substitute t is equal to t half, if we substitute t is equal to t half, then x is equal to a by 2. Then K0 is equal to, then K0 is equal to, K0 is equal to, then consider, we substitute in this rate constant equation, x, K0 is equal to x upon t, x is a reactive concentration, at t half, x is a by 2, we substitute x is equal to a by 2, and t is equal to t half, then t half is equal to, then t half is equal to a upon 2k0. The t half is equal to a upon k0. We rearrange this equation, t half is equal to a by 2 divided by k0, and we again rearrange, t half is equal to a upon 2k0. This is the equation for the half-life period of zero order reaction. T half is equal to a by 2k0. The time required for completion of 50% reaction is known as half-life period. When t is equal to t half, then initial concentration becomes a. If a is the initial concentration, then at half-life period, at t half, reactor concentration becomes a by 2. The 50% a by 2 is the 50% concentration is reacted. Then in rate equation k0 is equal to x upon 2, we can substitute x is equal to a by 2 and t is equal to t half. The t half is equal to a by 2 divided by k0. T half is equal to a upon 2 k0. This is the equation for the half life period of zero order reaction. T half is equal to a upon 2 k0. The half life period of zero order reactions is directly proportional to initial concentration of reactor. The half-life period of zero order reaction is directly proportional to the initial concentration of reactor, that is A. This is the second property, characteristic for the zero order reaction, the half-life period. The half-life period for zero order reaction is equal to T half is equal to A upon 2k0. The half-life period for zero order reaction is directly proportional to initial concentration of the reactor. And consider the last property. The nature of last property is unit. What is the unit for rate constant of zero order reaction? The last one is unit. Consider rate constant equation for zero order reaction. K0 is equal to x upon t. Concentration we can generally measure in mole per liter. X is a concentration and it is measured in mole per liter. And time is second. The unit of zero order reaction is mole per liter per second. The unit of rate of reaction and zero order reaction are same. We already discussed unit for rate of reaction in the solution phase reaction are mole per liter per second. The same unit for the zero order reaction, the unit for zero order reaction is mole per liter per second. These are three characteristics for the